in continuation of the previous clip, I am now taking the 10th problem from the question bank. 10th problem, it says calculate the moment of inertia of an angle section, or it is also called as L section also, they are both same. L section 100 by 80 by 10 mm passing through its centroid, about an axis passing through its centroid and parallel to shorter leg. Now it can be placed, I'll place it like this. This is the angle section or L section. This is the angle section or L section. I will take this as the longer one. This leg is 100 mm. This leg is 80 mm. And this thickness here, 10 mm. This is also 10 mm. You have to draw a rough sketch like this. A rough sketch is to be drawn. Now, we can divide it into two rectangles. It can be done either this way or this way. This, I can take this as one rectangle and this as another rectangle. Or I can divide it like this, take this as one rectangle and this as another rectangle. We can do it any way we want. You get the same answer, provided we do it correctly. We will get the same answer. Now I will take, you can try by, now I have taken this as one triangle, one rectangle, and this as the other rectangle. I will call one of them as 1 and the other one as 2. You can call anyone, no problem. You can do it other way also. You can do it this way also. You will get the same answer, provided you do it correctly. Now this is one reference axis. This is the vertical reference axis, this is the horizontal reference axis. Now we have to find out here, if it is a L section, we have to find out both x coordinate as well as y coordinate, because it is neither symmetrical this way nor symmetrical this way. It is neither symmetrical. So we have to find both x bar as well as y bar. Now this is the shorter leg. The shorter leg I have taken this way. Now if you get the center of gravity somewhere here, the entire section, then parallel to this means you have to find out Ixx. If you place this here and this leg here, then you will have to find out Iyy. Right. Anyway, first we will find out the center of gravity. Now the formula remains the same, whatever may be the shape, the formula is the same. X bar is equal to A1 X1 A2 plus A2 X2 divided by A1 plus A2. Same formula will be there here also. Now A1 will be, if I have taken like this, this is 90 by 10. So 90 into 10, 900 square mm. This way it is. A2 is 80 into 10, 800 mm square. This is the area. Now X1, it's the center of gravity will be somewhere here. So this is X1. X1 will be 10 divided by 2, that is 5 mm. Right? X2, that is this one, its center of gravity will be somewhere here. That will be 80 divided by 2. 80 divided by 2, that is 40 mm. Now Y1, that is from here to here. This will be 10 plus 10, that is this, from here to here it is 10. From here to here it is half of this length, that is 90 by 2, that is 45 plus 10, 55 mm. Then Y2 will be this distance from here to here, this is the reference line, so that will be 10 by 2, that is 5 mm. I think you are able to understand this. You are able to understand this, how I got these values. Now these are the reference lines now for finding center of gravity. Now X bar will be equal to A1 X1 plus A2 X2, only two rectangles are there, divided by A1 plus A2. 900 into 5 plus 800 into X2 is 40, divided by 900 plus 800, that is 900 into 5 plus 800 into 40 equals, if you must press equals after that, divided by 1700. 900 plus 1800 will be 1700. If you divide it, you get roughly 21.5 mm. That is this distance. From here to here, it is 21.5 mm. Now I want this Y bar. Y bar will be equal to A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 divided by A1 plus A2. A1 plus A2. 900 into 55 plus 800 into 5, Y2 is 5, divided by 900 plus 800. So 900 into 55 plus 800 into 5 equals, I get 53,500 divided by 1700. That gives me roughly 31.5 mm. It is 31.47. I have rounded it up as 31.5, no problem. This is 31.5, right? Now I got both this. Now I want moment of inertia about this axis. I want IXX. So what I will do, same thing I will do like we did in the previous problem, right? IXX will be equal to B1 D1 cube divided by 12, that is about this axis. B1 D1 cube divided by 12 plus area B1 D1 into Y1 minus Y bar the whole square. This is for the first rectangle. For the second rectangle, it is B2 D2 cube divided by 12. This is B2, this is D2 plus area, that is B2 D2. Into this distance. Now the distance between this line and this line, that is y bar minus y2 the whole square, y bar minus y2 the whole square. Now that will be IXX will be equal to b1 d1 cube. B1 is 10 into D1 cube is 90 cube. You have to take up to here only, 90 cube divided by 12 plus 10 into 90 10 into 90 multiplied by y1 is 55 minus 31.5 the whole square plus b2 80 into 10 cube d cube divided by 12 plus 80 into 10 into y bar 31.5 minus y1 is 5 the whole square. That is the substitution. Then take your calculator. Your calculator will give you 55 minus 31.5 equals whole square, the square of that, into this is 900 plus 10 into 90 to the power of 3 divided by 12. That gives me 1104525. If I press engineering, 1.1 into 10 to the power of 6. If you take this, it will become easy. Addition becomes easy. Same thing there also. 31.5 minus 5 equals 26.5 square of that into, here it is 80 into 10, 800 plus, this I got, plus 80 into 10 to the power of 3, 10 to the power of 3 divided by 12 equals something I got. Engineering, it will be 0.568, or I can take it as 0.57 into 10 to the power of 6, you will get. So 1.1 plus 0.7, 1.67 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 mm to the power of 4. You have to do it slowly. If you want IYY, what you will do is, you will transfer it like this, from here to here, from here to here. You will transfer, then D2 B2 cube by 12 plus D2 into B2 into here, it will be X bar minus X1. X bar, from here to here it is X bar, from here to here it is X1, the whole square. Plus similarly here, D2 B2 cube divided by 12 plus B2 into D2 into X2 minus X bar the whole square. Like that it will come. So similarly it has to be done. I hope you have understood it. If you have understood it, it is good.